If you're wondering if engineers are actually rich, how their salaries stack up next to other career opportunities, then this video is for you. We're going to be talking about a couple things within that coming up. Hey 1% Nation, I'm Jake Voorhees and you are watching the 1% Engineer Show, where we empower young engineers to rise to the top 1% of their career. On this channel, I'll give lots of tips, hacks, and tricks so that engineers can be as successful as possible. So if this is your first time here, consider subscribing. I see a lot of banter on YouTube and other platforms about the amount of salary that certain engineers make and why you should pursue engineering because of this. I'm not sure if that's the exact reason why you should actually become an engineer, because if you don't love it enough, if you're not passionate about that field, then you're never going to be able to become good enough to actually make a great salary and rise into management. But I want to address this really cool Business Insider article that came out a couple months ago entitled "What You Should Study in College If You Want to Become a Billionaire." And basically it's analyzing the most wealthy 100 people in the world, the Forbes 100 list for the world, and looking at what they studied in college and then breaking that down. Of the top 100, 25 people do not have degrees. So that says something in itself, guys. But of the 75 who did have degrees, the most prominent major choice in college was engineering. 22 of the 75 were engineers, which is almost 30%. I also want to say that 4 of the 75 were computer science majors, which to me is kind of like engineering. So if we consider that software engineering, and I don't really want to get into that discussion, but if we do, 35% of the most wealthy people in the world who have degrees were either computer science or engineering. And what it shows you is that engineers have this specific way of looking at the world, specific way of solving problems that lots of other people are incapable of. What most of these people did in order to become so successful within their engineering career is they created a solution for a problem and built a company around that and scaled it. And this is something that most people can't do. It takes an engineer to really be able to hone in on what is truly the challenge at hand and whatever industry it is that these people were focusing on and scale it and grow it. But the point is this: not everyone out there will be able to find this problem and then really build either a software solution or hardware solution, critically think about what is really going on, fix problems, provide solutions to totally rid the world of that challenge, that obstacle, that issue, and change the world with things that we build. That's what we do. So to get back to the topic at hand, are engineers rich? Sure, engineers make pretty good salary, but what I want to point out is that very few types of majors have the ability to change the world on such a big scale if they fuse it in with entrepreneurship and start a company from the problem that they solve. So in this video, I also want to talk about why it's very important to consider business and think about your MBA for your career and think about how maybe you can start a side hustle and you can solve the problems that you see by building a software solution or some sort of mobile application or web app or something. But this is how you can actually change the world and maybe become super wealthy along with that. I really do believe that's the best path. If you help a whole bunch of people, chances are the wealth and the power and the prowess and the prestige and the financial success is going to come from that. But you have to focus on that first. How can you solve people's problems? How can you help a lot of people overcome some challenges, some obstacles that you understand enough to develop a solution to those issues? So this is a real simple video today. Just want to address this a little bit and point out this cool article that I saw and also my view on how we as engineers have this unique ability to blend entrepreneurship and engineering to truly change the world and actually create a career that a lot of people cannot. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. I'm trying to bring a lot more videos in 2018. So comment below if you have some problem, some challenge that you are trying to figure out, and I can make a video about that. If you want the 1% Engineer Kit and access to the Facebook group, comment below. And as always, thanks for watching the 1% Engineer Show, guys, and stay hungry on your quest to become a 1% engineer. Cheers!